Hi, welcome to EPD Pathshala Spanish. We are in the paper entitled Advanced Spanish Grammar. I am Gaurav Kumar. I teach Spanish at the Center of Spanish, Portuguese, Italian and Latin American Studies in Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi. The title of this module is Imperfect Subjunctive 2. You have already seen the conjugation pattern for verb in the imperfect subjunctive. In this module, we will see the various contexts in which the imperfect subjunctive is to be used. Like the present subjunctive, the imperfect subjunctive is used mainly in multiple clause sentences which express states and conditions such as will, influence, emotion, commands, indefiniteness, and non-existence. The imperfect subjunctive is used when the context of sentence is in the past. The verb that expresses the following is either in the preterite, imperfect or conditional tense. First, wants, needs, demands, wishes. Second, emotion. Third, order, request or advice. Fourth, doubt or uncertainty. Certain conjunctions. Let's take these cases one by one. First, let us look into the case of the verbs of desire. The main clause expresses a wish, preference, want or need with regard to other people. The verb in the main clause is either in the preterite or imperfect or conditional. The main clauses such as desear que, preferir que, querer que, necesitar que will take up the subjunctive in the dependent clause. Let us see how there is a difference between these usages with the present subjunctive versus the imperfect subjunctive. In the present subjunctive, the sentence Quiero que Ana me compre las flores. I repeat, Quiero que Ana me compre las flores. In English, I want that Ana buys flowers for me. Here you can see with querer in the main clause, the verb in the dependent clause comprar has been used in the present subjunctive as querer was also in the present indicative form. Let us see the sentence now in the imperfect subjunctive form. Quise que Ana me comprara las flores. I repeat, quise que Ana me comprara las flores. In English, I wanted that Ana bought flowers for me. Here, as you can see, the verb in the main clause querer is conjugated in the preterite form as quise, and the dependent clause has the verb comprar, which is conjugated in the imperfect subjunctive. Let us take more examples. In the present subjunctive, for example, Prefiero que mi madre me haga las compras de ropas. I repeat, Prefiero que mi madre me haga las compras de ropas. In English it is, I prefer that my mother does the shopping for my clothes. The sentence in the imperfect subjunctive would be, Prefería que mi madre me hiciera las compras de ropas. I repeat, Prefería que mi madre me hiciera las compras de ropas. In English, I preferred that my mother did the shopping for my clothes. Again, in this sentence, you can see the main verb preferir is conjugated in the imperfect form of the past. Therefore, needing the imperfect subjunctive in the dependent clause for the verb hacer as hiciera. In the present subjunctive, the sentence Los padres desean que los niños jueguen en el parque. I repeat, Los padres desean que los niños jueguen en el parque. In English, the parents wish that the kids play in the garden. Here again, the verb desear in the main clause requires the subjunctive in the dependent clause, and the verb jugar is conjugated as jueguen. Now the sentence in the past subjunctive. Los padres deseaban que los niños jugaran en el parque. I repeat, los padres deseaban que los niños jugaran en el parque. In English, the parents wished that the kids play in the garden. As you can see, the context of the sentence is in the past and the main verb desear is in the imperfect past format. That is why the dependent verb jugar takes up again the imperfect subjunctive. Me pareció increíble que tú supieras dónde encontrarlo. I repeat, me pareció increíble que tú supieras dónde encontrarlo. Now, the verb, the sentence can be translated into English as, I found it unbelievable that you knew where to find it. Coming to the next set is that of verbs of emotion. The verb in the main clause is either in preterite, imperfect or conditional form, and it expresses hope, happiness, sadness, surprise, fear or regret with regard to other people, and will require the imperfect subjunctive mood in the dependent clause. Main clauses such as alegrarse de que, estar contento de que, esperar que, estar triste de que, gustarle a uno que, molestarle a uno que, sentir que, temer que, tener miedo de que. Let us see some examples. Sentí mucho que ustedes no estuvieran con nosotros anoche en la fiesta. I repeat, sentí mucho que ustedes no estuvieran con nosotros anoche en la fiesta. In English, it is translated as, I was sorry that you weren't with us last night at the party. Another sentence is, Me alegraba de que se casaran. I repeat, Me alegraba de que se casaran. In English, it is, I was happy that they were getting married. Let's take one more sentence. Esperaría que aprobaras el examen de matemáticas. I repeat, esperaría que aprobaras el examen de matemáticas. In English, I would hope that you pass the mathematics exam. The next sentence is, el profesor estaba contento de que los alumnos asistieran sus clases con frecuencia. I repeat, el profesor estaba contento de que los alumnos asistieran sus clases con frecuencia. In English, the professor was happy that the students attended his class regularly. Next sentence is, la gente estaba triste de que el gobierno no pueda controlar la inflación. I repeat, la gente estaba triste de que el gobierno no pueda controlar la inflación. In English, people were sad that the government couldn't control inflation. A mi madre no le gustaría que yo fuera a la escuela en motocicleta. I repeat, a mi madre no le gustaría que yo fuera a la escuela en motocicleta. My mother would not like that I go to school by bike. Temía que Pedro no quisiera devolverme mi dinero. I repeat, temía que Pedro no quisiera devolverme mi dinero. In English, I feared that Pedro did not want to return me my money. Next sentence is, me molestó que los vecinos pusieran la música tan alta. I repeat, me molestó que los vecinos pusieran la música tan alta. In English, it bothered me that the neighbors put the music so loud. Next sentence is, la gente tenía miedo de que el nuevo gobierno no cumpliera con sus promesas. I repeat, la gente tenía miedo de que el nuevo gobierno no cumpliera con sus promesas. In English, people were afraid that the new government did not fulfill its promises. Coming to the next set, the verbs of influence. If the main clause has verbs that express order, request, or advice for other people, then the dependent clause takes up the subjunctive. Such clauses are aconsejar, dejar, mandar, permitir, sugerir, decir, insistir en, pedir, prohibir, recomendar. Let us see some examples. Me pidieron que no llegara tarde. I repeat, me pidieron que no llegara tarde. In English, they asked me not to arrive late. Next sentence is, te aconsejé que dejaras de fumar. I repeat, te aconsejé que dejaras de fumar. In English, I advise you to stop smoking. Next sentence is, ella le sugirió al taxista que no condujera tan rápido. I repeat, ella le sugirió al taxista que no condujera tan rápido. She suggested the driver not to drive so fast. The next sentence is, el dueño insistió. Next sentence is, el dueño insistió en que los inquilinos pagarán el alquiler a tiempo. I repeat, el dueño insistió en que los inquilinos pagarán el alquiler a tiempo. In English, the owner insisted that the tenants paid the rent on time. Su hermano no le permitía que ella compartiera los juguetes con otros. I repeat, su hermano no le permitía que ella compartiera los juguetes con otros. In English, her brother didn't allow her to share her toys with others. Next sentence. El instructor le prohibió que nadara en la piscina. I repeat, el instructor le prohibió que nadara en la piscina. In English, the instructor forbade him to swim in the pool. Like in the case of present subjunctive, some verbs can be used both in indicative and subjunctive, depending upon what they tend to imply. If the verb is reporting a fact, then we use indicative, and in case it exerts an influence, then subjunctive is required. For the case of the indicative, let's see an example. Tu padre dijo que te dormiste ya que era tarde. I repeat. Tu padre dijo que te dormiste ya que era tarde. In English, your father said that you went to sleep as it was already late. The subjunctive format for this sentence is Tu padre dijo que te durmieras ya que era tarde. I repeat. Tu padre dijo que te durmieras ya que era tarde. In English, your father said that you go to sleep as it was already late. Verbs of doubt and negation. When a clause is introduced by a verb or phrase used in preterite, imperfect or conditional of doubt, the imperfect subjunctive is used in the dependent clause. The expressions are dudar que, negar que, no estar seguro de que, es incierto que, no es cierto que. Let us take some examples. Dudaban que yo hablara español. I repeat, dudaban que yo hablara español. In English, they doubted that I spoke Spanish. Next sentence is, ella negó que su hermano fuera el ladrón. I repeat, ella negó que su hermano fuera el ladrón. In English, she denied that her brother was the thief. Next sentence is, no estaba seguro de que él pudiera reparar el portátil. I repeat, no estaba seguro de que él pudiera reparar el portátil. The English version is, I wasn't sure that he could repair the laptop. Certain expressions, when don't express doubt, then they take up the indicative form. Such expressions are, no dudar que. No dudaba nunca que tú lo conseguirías. I repeat, no dudaba nunca que tú lo conseguirías. In English, I never doubted that you would achieve it. Era cierto que. Era cierto que el prisionero se había escapado de la cárcel. I repeat. Era cierto que el prisionero se había escapado de la cárcel. In English, it was true that the prisoner had escaped from the jail. When the main clause expresses current, verb in present tense, emotions, doubts, etc. about something that happened in the past, the verb in the dependent clause will be imperfect subjunctive. The construction structure is like this, present plus the imperfect subjunctive. Me sorprende que viajara solo a Alaska. I repeat, me sorprende que viajara solo a Alaska. In English, it's surprising that he traveled alone to Alaska. Next sentence is, es raro que no se casara con su novia. I repeat, es raro que no se casara con su novia. In English, it's strange that he didn't marry his girlfriend. The imperfect subjunctive with impersonal verbal phrases. If the impersonal verbal phrase is in the pretérito, imperfect or conditional, then it leads to the use of the imperfect subjunctive in the dependent clause. Fue una lástima que no pudiéramos ir de vacaciones. I repeat, fue una lástima que no pudiéramos ir de vacaciones. It was a shame that we were not able to go for vacations. Fue posible que el hombre colgara el teléfono. I repeat, fue posible que el hombre colgara el teléfono. In English, it was possible that the man hung up the telephone. Fue dudoso que mi sobrina me dijera la verdad. Fue posible que me mintiera. I repeat, fue dudoso que mi sobrina me dijera la verdad. Fue posible que me mintiera. In English, it was doubtful that my niece was to tell the truth. It was possible that she lied to me. Fue urgente que la ambulancia llegara dentro de 5 minutos. I repeat, fue urgente que la ambulancia llegara dentro de 5 minutos. It was urgent that the ambulance arrived within 5 minutes. Era importante que ella visitara al dentista. Era importante que ella visitara al dentista. In English, it was important that she visited the dentist. Era preciso que ellos vinieran a la fiesta. I repeat, era preciso que ellos vinieran a la fiesta. In English, it was necessary for them to come to the party. Let us see another example. Era posible que le diéramos un regalo al profesor. I repeat. Era posible que le diéramos un regalo al profesor. In English, it was possible that we gave a gift to the professor. Another sentence is, era menester que se obedeciera al rey. I repeat, era menester que se obedeciera al rey. In English, the translation is, it was necessary to obey the king. Let's take one more example. Era natural que los aldeanos trataran de defenderse. I repeat. Era natural que los aldeanos trataran de defenderse. In English, the translation is, it was natural that the villagers tried to defend themselves. Let's see further examples. Now, we have covered till now the main clauses being used in the pretérito and the imperfect subjunctive, and also the imperfect past with the imperfect subjunctive. Let's see further the use of conditional in the main clause with the imperfect subjunctive. Let us see some examples. ¿Sería posible que limpiaras la casa este fin de semana? I repeat. ¿Sería posible que limpiaras la casa este fin de semana? In English, the translation is, would it be possible for you to clean the house this weekend? Next example is, ¿sería necesario que la policía detuviera el criminal? I repeat, ¿sería necesario que la policía detuviera el criminal? In English, it would be translated as, it would be necessary that the police arrested the criminal. Using the conditional with further examples, let us take the next one. Sería bueno que ustedes se mejoraran. I repeat, sería bueno que ustedes se mejoraran. In English, the translation is, it would be good that you get better. The next sentence that we can consider is, sería imposible que Ana se fuera sin decirnos nada. I repeat, sería imposible que Ana se fuera sin decirnos nada. In English, the translation is, it would be impossible that Ana went away without saying anything to us. The next example is with the construction of convenir que. El presidente decidió que convenía que se dimitiera de la presidencia. I repeat, el presidente decidió que convenía que se dimitiera de la presidencia. In English, the translation is, the president decided that it was better that he resigned from the presidency. Let us take another example with the same construction of convenir que. Mind it, the verb convenir que has to be either in the pretérito, imperfect past, or the conditional, so as to demand the use of the subjunctive in the dependent clause. Let's see the next example. No convenía que la India favoreciera a Pakistán. I repeat, no convenía que la India favoreciera a Pakistán. In English, the translation would be, it was not advisable that India favored Pakistan. Next example can be of the structure importar que. Mind it, again the verb importar que in the main clause has to be either in the preterit or in the imperfect past or in the conditional, so as to require the use of the imperfect subjunctive in the dependent clause. Let us take some examples. A la madre le importaba que los niños no estudiaran. I repeat, a la madre le importaba que los niños no estudiaran. I repeat, a la madre le importaba que los niños no estudiaran. In English, the translation is, the mother was concerned that the kids did not study. Let us now take one more example with the same structure of importar. No me importaba que los vecinos pusieran la música muy alta. I repeat, no me importaba que los vecinos pusieran la música muy alta. In English, the equivalent translation is, I did not mind that the neighbors played loud music. Now let us take up the case of the verbs pensar and creer. Pensar and creer normally take up the imperfect past, and if they express a negative sentence, then the dependent clause takes up the imperfect subjunctive. It is to be kept in mind that pensar and creer in the positive sense will not take up the subjunctive, rather they go with the indicative. So, to fulfill the criteria of the imperfect subjunctive, one has to pay attention that pensar and creer are used in the negative. Let us see first the case of negative creer. The example is, no creían que pudiéramos ganar el partido. I repeat, no creían que pudiéramos ganar el partido. In English, they didn't believe that we could win the match. Negative pensar. No pensé que el internet fuera a cambiar mucho la enseñanza y aprendizaje de idiomas. I repeat, no pensé que el internet fuera a cambiar mucho la enseñanza y aprendizaje de idiomas. In English, the translation is, I didn't think that internet would change much the teaching and learning of language. So, we have seen that many uses of the past subjunctive are similar in function to that of the present subjunctive. But one has to keep in mind the distinction between the usages of both so as to avoid any confusion. Thank you. Gracias.